Hello.
Hello, I'm Konrad Graser. I was head of the DFAB house project here in the Nest, a research building of the EMPA, Swiss lab for materials science and technology in Dübendorf near Zurich.
In Dübendorf bei Zürich.
The nest consists of the backbone, and the structures inside here are the units. And the DFAB house is one of the units in the nest. We're here in one of the DFAB houses, four living quarters. Three are occupied and this one is kept free, so visitors can get an idea of what it's like to live in the DFAB house. Here we have an example of what can happen when residents pass on their experiences. For example, we learned that when sunshine comes through the wall in the morning, the room gets light very rapidly. And if you sleep lightly, it wakes you up. So we put curtains up here. If you want to sleep late, you can draw this curtain and it'll stay nice and dark. This is my favorite spot in the DFAB house. During the day, this corner is flooded with sunlight coming into the room through the wall. On the other side, I have a view of Switzerland's mountains. These leaning walls give you a sense of security and at the same time testify to what all the robots can do. I still think that's absolutely great. I could sit here all day long.
Toll und ich könnte den ganzen Tag hier sitzen.
This is likely to be the world's first robotically fabricated wooden house. The many wooden beams you see here are all part of the structure, so they're statically active. The forces at work in the building are distributed all through these wooden elements and throughout the whole structure. The modules are prefabricated in a hall by robots and the structures assembled on site. So it only took one day to put up this section of the building here.
Und dann hat es nur einen einzigen Tag gedauert, diesen Teil des Gebäudes vor Ort aufzustellen.
Here we are in the living room. Three staff members of EMPA live here, three researchers. And while living here, it's their job to pass on what it's like to live in the house, to give their feedback on living in such an unusual building. And that's important to us, because we're developing concepts for the future of construction. So, of course, the residents have an important part to play.
Und die Bewohner sind dabei natürlich auch ein wichtiger Bestandteil.
The structure of the ceiling above us here was achieved with 3D printing. They made a formwork using a 3D printer that can fabricate very large-scale elements. Then, it's cast in concrete.
Danach wurde das Ganze mit Beton vergossen.
Here we see a wall manufactured by a system called mesh mold. That's a robotic system where a robot on site assembles the inner workings of the wall. It was here and set up a kind of steel frame, the reinforcement, which forms the wall's static component and preserves the shape. Then this reinforcement is filled up with concrete, which then forms the clean surface, and you've got yourself a wall. These columns or facade elements we see here are also fabricated from concrete using an innovative process called smart dynamic casting. This slip-forming process shapes the elements by way of a flexible formwork system. This formwork that determines the shape is only about this tall. It gradually moves upward while being filled up with concrete. The advantage is that you can fabricate many different individually shaped elements using one robotic or digitized device. And if you look closely, you can see that all these columns are different from each other.
Nicht eine gleicht genau der anderen.